This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
I find that commercial a tad insulting to my intelligence. You know, the one, here's your brain. I've seen a lot of things on drugs, but I have never, ever, ever looked at an egg and thought it was a fucking brain, not once. Now, maybe I wasn't getting good shit, but, that's what I hate about the war on drugs, I'll be honest with you. It's what I can't stand, is all day long we see those commercials, here's your brain on drugs, just say no, why do you think they call it no? And then the next commercial is...
This is a beer commercial, and you know what that means. It's tits and ass beer, because nothing sells beer like tits and ass.
This Bud's for you.
Come on, everybody, let's be hypocritical bastards. It's okay to drink your drug. We meant those other drugs. Those untaxed drugs. Those are the ones that are bad for you. Nicotine, alcohol, good drugs. Coincidentally, tax drugs. Ooh, how does this fucking work?
Marijuana, the dried leaves and flowers of the Indian hempweed, is used in the form of a cigarette. Marijuana smoking, experts point out, can make a helpless addict of its victim within weeks, causing physical and moral ruin and death.
Did that just say possible death?
No, the government's like this. The government, they don't want you to use your drugs, they want you to use their drugs. So every night on TV, you see a weird-ass drug commercial trying to get you hooked on some legal shit. And they just keep naming symptoms till they get one that you fucking got, okay? They'll even tell you what the pill does. You see a lady on a horse or a man in a tub. And they just keep naming symptoms. Are you depressed? Are you lonely? Do your teeth hurt? What the fuck? Oh shit, they got one! I got that! I'm sick! I need that pill!
Do you know the warning signs of osteoporosis? Unfortunately, there aren't any.
Oh my god! I have osteoporosis!
New rule, if you believe you need to take all the pills the pharmaceutical industry says you do, then you're already on drugs.
It is. It's just a big scam. 80% of all prescription drugs are unnecessary, repetitive, or prescribed only to counteract the effects of other drugs. Oh my god. You know, it's just, and who names these drugs? You know, it's like somebody's getting high at a Star Trek convention.
I am so core.
Celebrex may increase the chance of heart attack or stroke, which can lead to death.
When taking Abilify, call your doctor if you have high fever, stiff muscles, and confusion, as these may be signs of a life-threatening reaction. In extreme cases, this can lead to coma or death. Coma or death. Death. Death.
Did that just say possible death? How are you going to put diarrhea and possible death in the same category?
What's here in Mexico?
Diarrhea.
Some people may have nausea, vomiting, diarrhea.
Seek immediate medical help if you experience an erection lasting longer than 4 hours.
Why is marijuana not legal? Why is marijuana not legal? It's a natural plant that grows in the dirt. You know what's not natural? 80-year-old dudes with hard-ons. That's not natural, but we got pills for that. We're dedicating all our medical resources to keeping the old guys erect, but we're putting people in jail for smoking something that grows in the dirt. You know, we have more prescription drugs now. Every commercial on TV is a prescription drug ad. I can't watch TV for 4 minutes without thinking I have 5 serious diseases.
Like, do you ever wake up tired in the mornings?
Oh my god, I have this. Write this down, whenever it is I have it. Half the time you don't even know what the commercial is. There's people running through fields or flying kites or swimming in the ocean. Like, that is the greatest disease ever. How do you get that? That disease comes with a hot chick and a puppy.
You know, that's why there's a drug problem, man. There's always a drug store, right? Every 3 or 4 blocks, that's a big sign.
Drugs.
Open all night.
Drugs.
We deliver
drugs.
Cut rate.
Drugs.
It's the biggest thing on this side. Cosmetics. Surgeries.
Drugs.
The weight of sadness. You may feel exhausted, hopeless, and anxious.
I have a job where I alphabetize insurance forms 45 hours a week, and I noticed I couldn't concentrate so well at my job, so my doctor put me on Adderall, and now I can just breeze through my workday. I don't even notice that my empty life is being pissed away underneath fluorescent tubes. I have no highs or lows, I have no good stories, I'm just, but I'm getting a lot of stuff done. I'm probably the most boring person I know, but look at me produce. I just go A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and J, K, I'm a B. La, 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 la.
You gotta enjoy your motherfucking life, that's all the fuck I'm saying. Enjoy your goddamn life. Life is fucking short, enjoy that shit. Some of y'all just need to smoke some weed and see if it don't help the quality of your motherfucking life. Well, why the fuck is it legal? I don't know. Aspirin is perfectly legal, but if you take 13 of them motherfuckers, it'll be your last headache. Long as you've been living, you ain't never heard of a motherfucker overdose on marijuana. You might have thought that nigga was dead. He ain't dead. He gonna wake up in 30 minutes, hungry enough to eat up everything in your house. That's the side effect. Hungry, happy, sleepy. That's it.
That's why I give my kids Kidstone Chewable Valium.
Kidstone Chewable Valium, the barbiturate the whole family can enjoy.
The schools, now it's all about self-esteem in the schools. Build the kids' self-esteem, make them feel good about themselves. If everybody grows up with high self-esteem, who's going to dance in our strip clubs? What's going to happen to our porno industry? These women don't just grow on trees. It takes lots of drunk daddies missing a lot of dance recitals before you decide to blow a goat on the internet for 50 bucks. And if that disappears, where does that leave me on a Friday with my new high-speed connection?
Matt violently and with great difficulty took his own life.
She ended the night by cutting her wrist.
I found Jacob hanging from the rafter in our attic.
It wasn't the disease that caused my daughter to viciously mutilate herself. It was the drug.
You can't sit down to TV at night and not see a half a dozen drug company commercials.
Millions of Americans watch the ads and then ask their doctors for prescriptions.
The reason we're seeing so much consumer advertising is because it works.
They do it by telling people, ask your doctor.
They can sell us almost anything.
Everything in our bodies is regulated by marijuana-like compounds that our bodies produce. So whether you're talking about the immune system, the nervous system, the digestive system, reproductive system, endocrine system, all of these coordinated body functions are regulated in a homeostatic manner by cannabinoids.
Until you know how Ambien CR will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Sleepwalking and eating or driving while not fully awake with amnesia for the event have been reported.
Congressman Patrick Kennedy was driving to work at 3 a.m. Why? Because he was on Ambien, which makes you crazy. And he thought he had to get up out of bed at 3 a.m. and go to work. But that's okay, because Ambien is a prescription drug.
Why would the pharmaceutical companies want you to be able to grow a plant in your backyard that might cure your menstrual cramps, might solve your headache, might give a terminally ill cancer patient some chance of gaining some weight and having a tiny quality of life? If you can grow that in your backyard, there's no net profit for corporations. We already know what net profit means to stock prices.
A spokeswoman for the Drug-Free America Foundation, I'm sure she has a tremendous sense of humor, is pleased that doctors will no longer be writing marijuana prescriptions.
You can't have people going out and selling anything and everything and declaring it a medicine. I mean, where do you draw the line on it?
Where do you draw the line on it? I tend to draw the line at what my doctors think will work. Or I ask a spokeswoman for the Drug-Free America. I feel I'm equally qualified when it comes to my health.
You have a group called the Partnership for a Drug-Free America. Well, first of all, of course, we don't have a Drug-Free America, never have, never will. But who are the funders? Who are the main funders, source of funding for the Partnership for a Drug-Free America, of all things? The tobacco industry and the alcohol industry. They are drugs. They are mind-altering, sometimes addicting drugs. Drug-free America indeed. But why do they do that? They spend huge money to reinforce the distinction between legal drugs on the one hand and illegal drugs on the other.
Some of y'all, look, I understand. If you ain't smoking weed because you got a good job, then by all means make your paper, boo-boo. But if you ain't got no job and you not smoking weed, I don't know what the fuck you are doing with your life. I really don't. I really don't. Don't give me that shit about it's a drug. It ain't no motherfucking drug. I done the research. It's just a plant. It just grow like that. And if you should happen to set it on fire, there are some effects. But that's not the same as drugs. Drugs, you got to do shit to it chemically. You got to add baking soda, water, stir it up. I don't know the recipe. I'm just saying.
Americans, let's face it, we've been a spoiled country for a long time. You know what the number one health risk in America is? Obesity. Obesity. They say we're in the middle of an obesity epidemic. An epidemic like it's polio. Like we'll be telling our grandkids about it one day. The great obesity epidemic of 2004. How'd you get through it, Grandpa? Oh, it was horrible, Johnny. There was cheesecake and pork chops everywhere. Nobody knows why we're getting fatter. Look at our lifestyles. I'll sit in a drive-thru. I'll sit there for... I'll sit there behind 15 other cars instead of getting up and making an 8-foot walk to the totally empty counter. Everything's mega meal, super size. Want biggie fries with that? Want a jumbo fry? Want a large? Want a biggie fry? Want a 30 burgers for a nickel? In fact, there's room in the bag. Take it. Want a 55-gallon drum of Coke with that? It's only 3 more cents.
When diet and exercise fail... Well, diet and exercise don't fail. A fact brought home last week by a new Duke University study that showed exercise, yes, exercise, is just as effective a cure for depression as Paxil and Zoloft. So ask your doctor if getting off your ass is right for you.
Now, where's my commercial?
I'm Bill Hicks, and I'm dead now.
By the way, keep drinking beer, you fucking morons.